Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can make use of before each execution block. In this video, let's see about how we can test a HTTP service. I'm using the same example which I have used in the last video. And in that, I have added a new service called data service, in which I have a function called getAllUsers, which is using HTTP client to invoke a GET request to fetch some data. We can also see the CLI has already created the spec file in which testing module is configured inside before each block. But if I run ng-test, it will fail because this data service is now having HTTP client as dependency. But in the spec file, we are not passing it as dependency. And so we get the error, no provider for HTTP client. Let's fix this. The error is clear that we need to provide the HTTP client. But if we provide HTTP client, it will invoke the real HTTP request. But as we are testing, we don't want the actual request to happen. So instead of using HTTP client, we can use the HTTP client testing module. And so we can see the error is gone. As a next step, we need to populate our test data. For that, we can use the HTTP testing controller, which we can inject here. And let's create our specification to test this getAllUsers function. It should get all users. Okay. Inside this specification, let me invoke the getAllUsers function from the service. I need to subscribe, otherwise nothing will happen. And as we are not invoking the original HTTP request, we need to mock some data. You can see I have created a folder. Inside that, I have created mock data in a file. I have created as a dictionary so that I can easily get any data using the ID. Now we can invoke a mock request using the expect1 function of testing controller. I'm passing the actual endpoint so that when this endpoint is hit, we can get our mock data. For that, we need to pass our mock data to this mock request using the flush method in the request. I'm going to use object.values, and so I can pass the data in an array. Now the setup is ready. Let's write our expectations. First, we need to make sure the data is coming. For that, I can use expect users to be truthy. Next, I can validate the number of users. We know we are passing 3 users. And so I can use expect users.length to be 3. Let me also find one particular user using the ID, and let me validate the content. I'm going to use expect this user.name to be this one. And finally, let me also validate whether this request method is get. For that, let me use request.request. Method to be equal to get. When I save this, we can see our test is passing. So this is how we can test HTTP request. Let me quickly create another function in the service to find the user by ID. And let me copy this specification and modify as per our need. Here I can invoke the getUserByID function by passing the ID as 1. It is going to give me 1 user, and I can expect that to be truthy. And let me also validate the name. And here I need to change the endpoint. And to the flush method, I can pass this particular user. And so when I save, we can see test is passing. To ensure no other HTTP request other than this one is invoked, we can use the verify method from testing controller. So ideally, I need to add this in both the specifications. But instead, like before each, we can use after each and move this code inside after each. And so if I save, we can see the tests are still passing. Okay, we have seen how we can test the HTTP get methods. Let's see how we can test the HTTP put methods. For that, let me create a new function called updateUser, in which I'm updating an user based on ID. Okay, let me write the spec for this. I can copy this and modify. First, let me invoke the updateUser function. To this, we need to pass the second parameter, which is going to be the changes alone. Let me change the age to 24, and I can pass these changes to this function. Inside this, let me also validate whether I am getting the same ID. And here, I need to make sure this is going to be put request. Also, I need to pass the modified user into my flush method. For that, let me get the original user and modify the age to 24. I am passing this modified user into the flush method. And so I can expect request.body.age equal to this changes.age. Now if I save, we can see our tests are passing. Hope you understood about how to test HTTP services. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.